grab your yoga ball, grab your blasters, grab some oil. If you have a sauna suit, put it on. I'm actually also gonna put a hat on. We're gonna do a warm-up, blast, activate, and some stretching using our Ashley Black yoga ball. All right, are you ready? Okay, let's start off. I have mine inflated, so it has a little bit of give to it. All right, there's not an exact science on how much air to put on. If you need more, add more, and just do what feels good for you. So we're gonna start off warming up. I want you just to sit on your yoga ball. Make sure that you are stable. So this is just going to partially support us. 60 to 70% of the weight is in my legs. This is just to balance on. All right, so my sit bones are kind of in the center. And are you ready? Let's just start moving the hips. Little circles, the only thing that's moving is my pelvis. We often are really stiff here. Now, if you haven't worn a sauna suit, it's a great way to get your body heat up quickly, and it retains heat. Switch direction, so I'm just circling, circling, getting some movement in those hip joints. Make sure you're stable on your ball. See, I'm just like, just using it for some support. It's probably has about 30% of my weight. And now shift left and right, left and right. My upper body is still, only thing moving is my hips. And now tilt your pelvis backward and then forward. Backward, forward, back, forward, back, forward. So just a pelvis tilt. Rest of my body. My legs are following the movement of my hips, but my upper body is still. Okay, now let's take it back to a circle. Reverse the circle. Reverse and reverse and reverse. Let's start, get your balance if you need to, and let's start moving the legs. Our legs are our largest muscle group, and we're going to do upper body work today, but getting the legs active during a warm-up will increase your heart rate and get the blood flowing quicker. So make sure you don't lose your ball. Just doing some side lunges assisted with the ball. Breathe, inhale, exhale. All right, let's stand up, grab a hold of the ball. I'm just gonna grab a hold of center. I'm going to keep a slight bend in my legs. Bring the ball up overhead. Bring it through your legs, looking back. Keep a bend in your knees. Inhale up, exhale down. 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 All right, now keep a bend in your knees. Take the ball over to the right, left palm down. Take it across your body, right palm down. Bring it in front, left palm down, inhale. And exhale, inhale, and exhale, inhale, and exhale, inhale, exhale, inhale, keep slight bend in the knees, exhale. Now let's reverse direction. So left palm facing up, inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale, inhale. Exhale, inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale, And let's get some rotation in our spine. I still have a slight bend in my knee. I am going to extend the ball, turn. My eyes are following the ball, looking to the right. Come to center, look left, center. My hips are staying forward. My shoulders are staying square with the ball. Turn, turn. Exhale on the twist. Inhale, exhale. 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 All right, bring that ball down in front of you. We're gonna take now and push the ball out, slight bend in the knees. Extend it out, roll your spine up. Push the ball away, flat back, belly button going towards the floor. Exhale. Roll it up one vertebrae at a time. Push the ball away. And roll it up. It's the cat-cow. Push the ball away, spine going towards the floor, flat back. And bring the spine, the belly button up to the spine. Curve in the spine, one vertebrae at a time. Push it away. And roll it up. Push it away. And roll it up. All right. Let's take, set the ball down, roll our shoulders back. I have sweat dripping out of my sauna suit. My body's warm, those shoulders warm. Rotate back and back, back, back. Follow it with your eyes, turning your body like you're doing the backstroke. A little bit faster, turning with your body. Inhale, exhale. And now do the swimmer stroke forward. Reaching forward, shoulders forward, and pull it back. Open that chest. Reach forward, open the chest, reach forward. Take it to the side. And reach, reach and pull. Getting down that whole entire lateral side here. And come center, other side. Reach straight out, pull. All right, are we ready to blast? Okay, I hope that you are as sweaty as I am. Mine is like completely wet. All right, so I'm going to leave my bottoms on. Oh, here, can you see this puddle? All right, so if you don't have a sauna suit, they are great for blasting. I'm completely warm. I'm gonna keep my bottoms and my hat on for now to stay warmed up, and we're gonna start blasting. So let's just start out putting oil on. And I have an assortment of blasters. You can use any blaster that you have. I'm gonna start out with my Master Blaster across my pecs. So just get comfortable. If you want to sit, stand, lay, this is your session. Make it work for you. Just try to use good posture in whatever you're doing. Rather than, you know, hunched over and, all right. Go down my arm. It's nice when you get all sweaty like that because you don't need as much oil. I'm in a dry spot here. I don't know if I'm missing. And I'm going to switch to my mini one. I'm going to switch arms. I'm right around my armpit. You gotta get all those muscles, the tendons and ligaments. I don't go digging in my armpit, but I do get all these muscle attachments. Switch to a mini two. I'm just going to take my face blaster, quickly go over. I got good blood flow. All right. I'm going to put my sauna suit back on, and we're going to do a little bit of activation now. Putting the sauna suit back on. A couple of things, because I want to get hot again, and it also keeps the ball from getting all oily. Few different levels here. We're going to start out doing some push-ups on the ball. If you're new to push-ups, this is going to be the beginner, okay? Is to put most of your body weight on the ball. Bring your hands outside of your shoulders. You're going to push through. You're going to keep your gaze right down here so you get a neutral spine. And you just push up, taking those elbows out. And then to increase the difficulty, just have that ball go lower, all right? And if you're more advanced, you can take the ball the other direction. You can put it anywhere on your thighs. It just gives you more body weight that you have to lift. And even for more advanced, you can take it all the way down. So I'm just going to kind of go in the middle, okay, and take it down, up, down, and up. Inhale, exhale up, inhale down, exhale up, inhale down, exhale up, inhale down. Exhale up, take it back and stretch. And come up for another set. Take it down and up. Inhale down, exhale up, inhale down, exhale up, inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale, inhale. Exhale and take it back and stretch. One more set. Down, up, inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale. Two more. And release, stretch that out. All right, let's stand up. And just grab a hold of your ball, get a bend in your knees. All right, and squeeze. Pressing my palms towards each other. Should feel it all through your pecs. Exhale on the squeeze. And press and hold. Release. And just kind of move around. Release that, and let's do another set. Bring it down, slight bend in the knees, chest is open, and press the hands together. And press and hold, press, hold, push, push, push on that ball, push, 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 and release, shake it out. One more set, slight bend in the knees, looking right down past the ball and press together. And press and hold. Your arms might start shaking. That's good. It's just muscle fatigue. And release. Shake them out. Take a drink anytime you need it. You want to stay hydrated in your sauna suit. You want to stay hydrated out of your sauna suit too, but you really sweat. All right, let's go to triceps. All right, so we want to put some of our weight on the ball to assist us, okay? And play around and find your spot depending on your level. Bring your hand down, right kind of in line with your elbow here, and then take this other hand and put it on the ball. All right, our feet are stacked, one in front of the other, and take it down and push up. This is for the tricep. The closer your ball is to your hand, the easier it'll be to make it more difficult. Move that ball down and you'll have to push up more of your weight. So put the hand on the ball, down, push up. Push through the palm of that hand. That is all tricep. Your triceps will be on fire. Release. We're gonna switch sides. So find your happy spot for your weight distribution on the ball. Take it down. Come on your elbow. You can stay on one knee too, however you can keep balance, okay? Stagger your feet, bring your hand down, blow your shoulder, other hand on the ball, and I need a little more weight on, okay? And take it down. Inhale down, exhale up, inhale. It's just simply a bend in the elbow. Oh, does that burn the tricep? One more, and release. Great, gonna shake them out. Let's do another set. Switch sides, come over. Get your weight situated. Bring that arm down below your shoulder, other hand on the ball. All right, kind of want to be on your side here. Push up, arm extension. So we're doing two things. We're activating muscle and we're heating back up to blast. All right, come on your side. Put that hand below, wrist below the shoulder, hand on the ball, and bend. Release, switch sides. Wrist below shoulder, other hand grab the ball, get your feet stable, and bend and push. Release. If you're getting tired, move that ball closer to your stabilizing, your working arm. You won't be lifting as much of your body weight. Okay? All right. Hand on the ball and push. And release. Stretch it out. All right. next to the triceps. Bring that ball back behind us. We're going to push our palms together slightly. Take a bend in the elbow. Bring our feet a hip width apart. Slight bend in the knees. Hinge it forward. Elbows are bent, pointed towards the ceiling. Palms are placing together and extend it back. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Hold back in extension and lightly press those palms together. Release. Let the tension out of your neck. Nice and gentle, sway back and forth. Next set, stable on your legs. Elbows are up towards the ceiling and extend it back, back. Tricep extension. Take it back, push those palms together. Release. And roll that neck, chin to chest, releasing any tension. Last set. I get my bottom stable, slight bend in the knees, slight hinge forward, elbows up. Extend that ball and extend. Exhale on extension. Hold it back. Press those palms together. Last set. Eee. Ah, 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 ah. Oh, and just drop that ball. And shake those arms out. All right. Let's do another blast. We'll lightly blast those arms just to release some tension. Make sure my top is still on. Okay. Oh, that felt really good. And I'm just gonna go. All right. So if you, can you see the sweat? It's just dripping off of me. Nice and warm, ready to blast our stomach. So I'm just going lightly just to flush out those muscles that we just worked. It'll help reduce the soreness tomorrow. All right, let's blast our abdominals. If you want to use your ball, go for it. I'm just gonna put something over it to keep some of the oil off. All right. So, grab a blaster. I'm gonna use my master blaster. And I'm just gonna lean back. If you keep your feet wide, it'll give you more stability. And actually, you know, I think I want this ball lengthwise to give me more support. Oh, comfortable. I'm gonna get all the way on the ball. Find a comfortable position for you. Keep blasting. getting my obliques. Get a drink anytime you need it, or keep blasting. I'm gonna grab my mini too. I'm just gonna grab a full size. All right, I think I'm gonna switch to my back now. I did bring my full size with extenders to do my back. The extenders are less than $5. They're available in the electric section at hardware stores online, 90 degree 1 inch, okay? I'm doing my neck, my traps and stuff as well. I'm gonna go up to my neck area now. And get the front as well. I'm gonna get the SCM behind my ear. Switch to my mini one. Go up and on your occipital. All those neck muscles come up and attach there. Alright, we ready to do some core activation. Make sure your abdominals are ready. If you have any extra skin that's moving, you know, sometimes your pregnancies and stuff, just brace it with a hand. I've had a lot of weight fluctuation from pregnancy and fibroid female issues. All right, here we go. I'm gonna throw my top back on. All right. Get a drink whenever you need it. Let's do a rolling plank. So you put this ball wherever you need it. If it's up under your midsection, it's going to be the easiest because it's going to be holding up more of your weight. Okay? So we're just going to come onto our forearms. Our elbow is right below our shoulder. Our hands are planted firmly, pressing into the ground. Our neck is neutral, looking right in this space here, and we're going to roll forward and backward. Forward, this is for the core. All right, so that is very easy for me there. So I'm going to take this ball and move it all the way down by my knees. Now I'm supporting my weight. Okay, so backward, forward. Inhale back. Exhale, forward.
Inhale back. Exhale forward. Your abs should be engaged. Neutral spine. Inhale back and exhale forward. Inhale back and exhale forward. All right, so now you can just bring those knees in to get off the ball if that's easiest. Move your belly around, release the back. Push the hips left and right. Look down towards your belly button to release the neck. And let's do another set. So take the ball to your comfort level and shift back and forward. Inhale back, exhale forward. Inhale back, exhale forward. Pulling that belly button into your spine. Everything is engaged and strong. And release. Swing out those hips, curl the back up, push it down. Release any tension, release your neck. Again, go to your comfort level. You never want to have any joint pain, only muscle discomfort that the muscle is working. All right, so shift it forward, back. So I have it too far forward this time and I can only feel my arms because I don't have enough weight for my core. There we go. And release. You can move the ball, stretch that out, release the back, push the hips side to side, release the neck. All right, so let's see. Let's do our obliques. We'll come over to this side, and you can come into a side plank, or if you're a beginner, just keep that knee down. All right, bring the arm to the side, and we're gonna inhale, exhale, reach. Should be all in the obliques. Just a side crunch. Exhale. Release, go to the other side. And stay on my knee, hand, and glide up. Exhale. Sets of 10 approximately, if I'm counting. Sometimes I am, sometimes I'm tacking. And so my hips are stacked one on top of another, and I've got my foot out for stability, my elbows below my shoulder, and I am reaching up. So right here is my obliques that's bringing me up. Release, take it to the other side. So never skip on working your obliques, because as you develop your obliques, it'll make your waistline tighten up, and that always, you know, helps with that hourglass shaping that we all would desire, I think. If you're advanced, bring your hand up. If you're really advanced, bring them both up. I'm stuck in my jacket. Form, keep your hips stacked. Exhale up, inhale down. Beginner, you can be right here Doesn't matter what level you are, you just want to work the oblique right there. Tight, tight, tight. And release. All right. Next, let's do our back. So I'll switch to this side. I'm gonna grab a drink. All right, let's come onto our ball. We're just going to put a little weight into our ball. You can bring your feet out, separate them for stability, and look down in between your hands, and exhale, bring it up. This should be for your low back. It's just a hinge up from the hips. Bring it back down. This time, take your hands right below your shoulders. Press up, look up, look to the right, look to the left. Release, bring it down. Hands up, bring it up. Hinging at the hips. We're compressing our lower spine, working those lower back muscles. Release, hands below the shoulders. Push it up, look up, gaze up. Inhale, exhale, look to the right. Inhale, exhale, look to the left. Inhale, exhale. Release, one more set. Bring your hands up and hinge up. Release, hands below the shoulders. Push up into cobra, gazes up, heart is open. Look to the right, look to the left. And release, bring it down. This time bring your hands straight back, palms down, and bring it up. Hold for a ton, breathing. And push those hands down. Tiny pulses. Release. Release that low back. Curl the belly button into the spine. Release. Straighten those legs back up. This time, airplane arms, bring them out. Lift the body up. Press those hands up and down. And release. Release that back. Curl the belly button into the spine. Push it down to the floor. And last one. This time we're going to be our hands straight out in front of us. And come up. Hold. And now swim it out. And release. Cow and cat. Bring it up and down, up and down. All right, come onto your back. We're gonna get these upper abdominals. Bring your ball overhead, right? I'm gonna kind of grab in the middle of it. Cross your right foot over your left and do a tiny crunch. Exhale. Keep everything relaxed. My hands are just supporting the ball. Release. And switch legs, put the left foot over the right. So I've just got my ball in my hands, nice and gentle, okay? And bring it up. Small movement, exhale. Inhale back, exhale up. and release. Now bring that ball down between your knees and bring the feet up into tabletop. And we just want to lift those hips and lift. And release. All right. Let's just, while we're right here, let us just windshield wiper, release that low back, release those hips, windshield wiper those legs, left and right, nice and relaxed. Stretching should never be painful. It should be relaxing, just going to a point of resistance. Oh, that feels really, really good. And come up. Let's stretch out this back. So just come up on your sit bones, shake left and right. Move some of the extra out of the way. And let's just take and put our left hand on the right side of the ball. And we're going to take, we're going to extend forward, look back at the right hand, release, right hand, left side of the ball, push forward, look back at that left hand, release, switch sides, release, inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale, and now just take, pushing that ball out, looking down, nice and gentle. Roll it up, one vertebrae at a time. Come down, flat back, pushing it out, looking down, rolling it up. Nice and flowing, push it down. Roll it up, push it down, roll it up, come onto your knees, your toes can be together, your knees can be separated for comfort, and bring the ball about 8 inches in front of you, and just push it away, exhale down, inhale up. This time, put your hands together on the ball, your palms together. Push it away. You should be able to feel that in your lats. Push it away. Exhale down. Inhale up. Exhale down. Inhale up. Exhale down. Inhale up. All right. Let's take. And let's just push the ball across, stretching out that shoulder. And up. Push the ball to the side, bringing the chest down. And up. Push the ball to the side. Hold down and take this other hand and cross your body. Okay? Should be a nice stretch. Inhale, exhale. No pain in stretching. Release. Let's switch sides. Put that ball on your other side. Stretching that arm out. So bring it across. You gotta start with the ball close to you. So push the ball out and bring it up. Push it out, bring it up, push it out, bring it up, push it away. Take this other arm, cross it, and go down. It's a really good stretch. All right, triceps, bring your elbows onto the ball. Move your body away from the ball. You can put your palms together and just push down. Stretching the triceps right through here. And release. Take that ball behind us. And just bring it back. Open up that chest so the ball is between my feet and I got my hands on it. It'd be similar to a camel pose in yoga. So you're pushing your hips forward. Chest is open. Shoulders are wide. My gaze is up. I'm inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale, inhale. And I'm just gonna turn around, bring it in front, push the ball away, and in, push, and in, pushing it away, and in, and. Come over to the side, push that ball away, stretch, bring it back, push it away, like a half moon. Push those hips to one side, arms are reaching towards the ball, pushing the ball away, push, the other side. Push it away, hips go to the other side, reach and stretch, great lateral line stretch. All right, let's drop the ball. Let's just take our chin to our chest. Look down at the armpit. You can bring our arm up, ceiling up, elbow up towards the ceiling, and just grab gently to your occipital area, gently pulling down. Release. Bring your chin to center. Gently look up. Couple of shoulder rolls back. And take that chin down towards the other armpit. Inhale, exhale. Bring that arm up, bend, elbow pointing towards the ceiling. Gently grab the back, looking towards the armpit. Release, gently rolling that chin towards the chest. Looking up, a couple of shoulder shrugs. Help release those traps. All right, let's do our hands. If you want to blast your hands, your face and the rest of your scalp now, it's always recommended to, you know, use a mirror for your face. But great job. All right, have a great day.